Hi, my name is Carlin Holland. I'm here today to do corpse paint on myself in honor of Black Metal History Month here on Metal Injection. Let's get started. First, maybe a little bit about design for face. Corpse paint started back with rock and roll, maybe Kiss, you could say, was one of the first bands to do face painting black and white. I wouldn't quite call Kiss corpse paint yet. They put designs on their face, stars, things like that. They didn't really resemble something that was dead or decaying, but that's certainly where metal has taken it today. Black metal bands are most noted for doing this, especially ones that like to frolic around in the snow and take really high contrasty black and white pictures of themselves so they look like ghosts running through a forest. The effect is very, very eerie, and that's certainly what I'm going to go for today. Some bands have a very clean style, like Immortal, crisp lines crossing their face, but I'm going to go for something a little more artistic, I guess. All right, here we go. Makeup I'm using is pretty cheap Halloween makeup you can get just about any party store. If you want to go to something that will last a little longer, probably be a little better for your skin, Ricky's sells stage makeup, and a lot of other places sell stage makeup, which you can get in any color, white, black, purple, rainbow. You could be the first gay rights crowd corpse paint wearer if you wanted to. There you go. Always remember, put the white on before the black unless you want this kind of smudgy look. Gel eyeliner can be your deepest, darkest friend, and when it's finally time to get it all off, go for the cold cream. In honor of Black Metal History Month, Metal Injection is inviting you to send in your best pictures of corpse paint all month long. This is Carlin Holland, signing off.